you guys come on up.
I'm Nick.
I'm Mr. Nick.
And
Neil.
Neo from YoungZone, which I don't know a whole lot about. I'm eager to learn about what you've got. Yeah, right. I've heard about it. I saw it at the press thing. And then Nick at Spin Master.
Yeah, nice to meet you.
Nice to meet you. I don't think we've met.
No.
Wonderful. So, guys, we're going to talk about augmented reality. And just to be clear, you're all real, no avatars. let's look up at the screen there. And so first off, we have Nick. How do you say your last name?
Beliaeff.
Beliaeff. He's a vice president of production from Spin Master Studios. Mili, help me.
Tharakan.
Tharakan?
That's right.
Who's the director of technology at Tilt. And what is Tilt?
Tilt. We're a smart home textile company. And I'll share a bit more during.
And you're based where?
In the US, but we're quite a global team. I'm based in London, and we have a team in India as well.
What I'm excited about, this is a multinational fabrics company that's getting into the kids' technology space,
that's right.
And so that's really cool. And then Neo...
Xiong.
Xiong?
Yeah, in Chinese, that's me in beer.
Okay. And we're going to see a... Looks like you have something there in your slide. From YoungZone, right?
Yeah. Also, you can call it NeoBear. It's
NeoBear
branding. Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah.
And so you you brought one with you, some NeoBear.
Yeah, that's MagNeo, our new product.
Awesome. Good. Yeah. All right. So get ready to go jump into augmented reality. This is our last panel before we get it to Dean. And so let's run down and see what do we have first, because I know we've got some. Start with spin tails. And we can jump to the camera whenever you'd like, okay?
Yeah.
As I know this is going to be a big part of that, so be ready, you guys. There's a clicker right there. You can move through your own slides. Take us on a spin tail.
Yeah. Are you ready for the show? So, like you asked, Tilt, we're a young company, a small company, but we have a big vision to explore the new frontiers of textiles. And we're excited about this new frontier where it's textiles that delight you, it engages you, it animates, it reacts, and it immerses you. And we love technology, and a lot of this is enabled by technology, but we're not defined by it. Maybe that's a little scandalous to say at a tech show, but we do really bring technology very seamlessly into our textiles to create very magical experiences. At Tilt, we focus on two categories. One is education and entertainment for family and children, and the second is wellness and health, again, for families, children, and the elderly. Today, I'd love to present to you Spin Tails. This is our first product that we're launching here at CES. We're very excited to share this with you. We have two products, actually, Spin Tails Enchanted Duvet. It's a duvet cover and pillow, which has three classical stories embedded in them. You might be familiar with Little Red Riding Hood, Jack and the Beanstalk, and the Three Pigs. So this duvet comes alive and becomes the landscape for these characters and these stories to play out on. We also have the Jungle Rug, which is what I'll demo to you today. It's, again, a simple rug that turns into this wild jungle with animals all running around in your living room, and kids love this one. We really think about multidimensional storytelling in the product. And when I talked about technology, we use technology, but what we really want to focus on is the experience that children have with our product. It's not the tech that's the wow, it's the whole experience of storytelling. And we wanted to layer that storytelling experiences. So kids are very used to using an app today. They listen to stories in an app, but we wanted to enhance that experience and make it much more magical, very immersive and interactive for them. So for that, we brought in augmented reality as one of the tools to create that immersive experience. We also have very fun interactive activities that engage them in the story and takes them through the story as they progress.
There's a video out there.
I would actually just prefer to use more of my time to do the demo, if that's okay. I think that speaks.
Yeah, so let's wait to do the demo.
Okay,
and keep.
Sure.
What slides are next?
That's it. That's my last one.
Okay. Do any of you have slides?
Did you?
Nick? No?
Nope.
No? Oh, good. Okay. Well, let's move to the next. What's new at Spin Master?
Sure.
Spin Master, we're over a 20-year-old toy company headquartered out of Toronto, Canada. Very broad portfolio with such things you may, Hatchimals is the big thing this Christmas, but we also do Paw Patrol, Meccano, Spy Gear, Air Hogs, and more and more and more. For us, for me, I run Spin Master Studios, which is the branch of Spin Master, where we're chartered to deal with, bridge the connection between physical play patterns and digital play patterns. I think as you see now that as technology becomes more and more accessible to children, they stop playing with physical toys a little bit earlier and start moving to tablets and smartphones and the hand-me-downs. And so we want to find a way to keep that tactile engagement going because we find that there's a lot more learning and fun if they're actually physically playing with something. And so my group's chartered to try and bridge that. We've done it with such things where we have, with Mechanoid, we have, which is a little erector set robot that you can build, and we have an animation builder and motion recognition and things like that. So it's a little Internet of Things type of thing. We also have stuff where we do companion apps with the Helix Sentinel, which is a first-person video drone where you can then post to your favorite social media site and do all sorts of fun things with that. And then for us, we've also been very big believers in augmented reality. We started investing in research in it in 2014, and we released our first augmented reality toy last fall, about 4 months ago, 3 months ago, and it's a Air Hogs mission drone. And with it, you have Matt, much smaller than Millie, is about a half meter by a meter, and we use that to transform the kids' living room or playroom or whatever it is into an augmented reality universe, and we turn it into a sci-fi universe where you then fly the real drone around in this augmented reality universe, do missions, stuff that would be very akin to, like, you know, helicopter heroics. You're putting down a grappling hook and rescuing civilians. You're getting commandos to jump out of your drone and go out and fight the alien invasion, things like that. Our next product, and we'll be showing a movie about this later, hopefully you have that now, is Nitro Boost, which is car racing. And for us, it's really the next step beyond drone. With drone, it's a very solitary experience. And for us to level up the play immersion, you know, when you have cars, the first thing you think of is racing, and it's much more social and communal. And so in this one, you have a much smaller mat. The AR technology has moved forward so much, there's a lot more SLAM, which is sort of predictive technology. And so again, we'll transform your room. In this case, it's into a race arena, and you can race against your friend's physical cars, or you can race against augmented reality cars.
So that's Nitro Boost. And
yes,
we're going to try to get a movie. I'd rather they play it from the back. Are you guys going to be possible to play that? And then we can jump to the camera if that works. I'm a little leery of messing around with my HDMI settings on this PowerPoint, but we'll try to get that going. Spin Master obviously is one of the major technology leaders in toys and robots and drones and everything, really. Is Nitro Boost maybe your headline of the show?
For us, it's central to what we're talking about at CES.
Is it absolutely Downstairs?
No, it's at the Luxor.
Is this top secret or is it out?
No. It's coming out this fall, and we're just beginning to talk about it now.
Okay, so let's try to. We'll, any luck on the video? You think? Yeah, I'm getting the thumbs up. So maybe we can see it. These guys have been. I've been throwing them about every curve I can, so I really appreciate all the help we have in the back. So, Neo, we can kind of get started on you. You guys just take over the screen whenever you're ready.
Yep.
Or do you need slides? You don't need slides. Yeah, Neo?
Yeah.
Do you have slides?
Yeah, I need to do.
Let me see what I got. Oh, yeah.
Volume.
All right, we're going for it. This is the video. So we're staying at Spin Master.
That is not the soundtrack.
That's not the sound, I know that for sure. That's the other thing. It just wouldn't be a tech show unless we threw some stuff at you. All right, tell us what we're seeing.
Right, so right now, actually it would be great if we could start at the beginning since it got truncated.
You're pushing it, aren't you?
I'm trying, right? It's what I'm here for. So, thank you. Go ahead, hit play. So here you'll see a little bit of the transform, where you take the mat and the physical cars, and this is what you actually see from your mobile device, whether it's, so this is a live feed from a tablet in this case, but it works tablet and phone, iOS or Android, and you can really see that from an observer standpoint, it's a car racing on the floor like that, but from the kid driving the car, it's that transformative experience where you're in that city, you're seeing the enemy cars, you're rolling over stuff, and what's really neat is because we control the telemetry in the car from the CPU and the device, when you impact with one of those virtual cars, you will actually crash. And so a lot of the spin outs and stuff that you saw from the car was from a physical car crashing into an augmented reality object. And we really think that bridge between the physical and digital is a little magical. But what's also interesting is from a kid's perspective, because they've grown up with technology, they don't care.
Yeah.
Really? Everyone in the room thinks it's neat and like, wow, we haven't seen anything before. They've grown up with it and they just expect it to work. And it's interesting because it makes you focus on the fun, right? You have to focus on the fun. You have to focus on the engagement because they don't care about the technology. Mm. For them, it's just what's there.
Wow. Well, thanks. I'm glad we got to see that because it's those are optical. They're little
the
cars.
The cars? No, it's a physical toy about the size of that clicker down.
No, I mean, do they sense what's the sensor technology?
So with SpinMaster, we have some patents around the technology.
Let's switch back to this the slides. You have PowerPoint. Yeah.
So the mat, we're using an off-the-shelf planar tracker to create that augmented reality universe. And then we have our own Bluetooth connection to the car. And it's establishing a physical relationship between the persons that are driving where the car is. And then we have a control system that blends where you are in the physical world and where you are in the digital world and allows us to do, you know, I hit a AR object and crashed. Right, and so it's those three prongs in the technology is what allows us to do that.
I have a feeling your offices would be really fun to visit in Canada.
Yeah, well, our headquarters are in Canada. I'm out of the Los Angeles office. We have offices all across the world. It's a toy company. It's very much Willy Wonka type of thing, where literally in our office there's toys spilling out in the aisle.
And then I know this is on topic, but you bought Toca Boca.
We did last year. We're super excited. They're the leader, the absolute leader in the kids space, and Toca Boca and Sago Mini, and we soft launched Toca TV towards the end of last year. And so for us, it's again, you know, for the company.
So Nick,
we're trying to bridge that gap.
You don't sound or look like Bjorn Jeffrey, but
I'm not.
You are Toca Boca. how is it going? Thumbs up, thumbs down, Toca Boca.
Oh, thumbs up.
Let's see it.
Two thumbs
up. That's what I was saying.
Yeah, no. Those guys are great and they're killing it.
Yeah, awesome. Good. Glad to know. All right. Neo.
Yeah.
The slides are yours. Do you have the clicker? There it is. Show us what you got, and then we got to play. We got to try the augmented reality.
Okay.
Rug.
So I'm Neo, CEO of the Neo Bear, and I'm from China. Actually, my English not good, so I repair some papers. Just let me do the introduce. No more question. Okay. Okay. I'm glad to have this opportunity to share some of our interesting products with you today. And this is the first time we go into the CES. Our company is focusing on the AR learning for children. Most people interested in AR technology right now, we proud to be one of the first players in the repeatedly growing field. The first players, Neo Bear is the very earlier started a few children in the field of the AR products. Focus. We launched the first generation of products in 2013. And in 2014, we launched a product name is Pop-Up Zoom.
1 million have been sold just in 1 month. And this product won a lot of award in China. Also, in last year, we won the Parents' Choice Award in United States. After this, we have developed more AR products. These are some of our most selling products in China, and some of which last year also entered the US market. Based on our solid market performance, in the last 18 months, we were able to acquire a total of $60 million investment capital from well-known companies like GGV, Qualcomm, CTE, New Horizon, and the others. Okay, that's not our the most important topic. We go to the CES, want to promote our new product, Magni. And let us have a look.
Feel the fire burning. You take control. You wanna get away somewhere private. Just you and me in my t-shirt. She's a beauty queen, don't need no makeup. She's my everything. Tonight she asks, what you think of me? And lay back. Honestly, you blew up. Life, so colorful, so beautiful. My whole world is black and white. I can't wait to do it right. Your blue eyes making life so colorful, so beautiful.
Kind of a mashup, kind of works. You can talk over this right now, but I think we get the idea. And I really want you to hold up your magnifying glass.
Yeah, it looks like a magnifier. That's why we call it Magneo.
Can I yeah. walk it around? This is kind of mind-blowing. Is it looking at me? Oh my God.
Yeah, the greatest feature, it's round screen and circular UI. So we have spent a long time to designing the hardware and the software.
How are you need a selfie mode. But I think the round screen is kind of like, wow, you just don't see a lot of these. So cool. All right, we are running out of time, but I really want to show the rug, and I'd like to actually let you see this. I mean, if you can. Are you set with your slides? Is it good?
It's good. So, okay. If anyone interested our product and need more information, so you can visit our booth 44338 Sands Hall Level 2.
Cool. So you got to try this. And Dean Takahashi is coming up next, so let's get him ready to stay on schedule. While we do this, we got to look at the rug.
I'm ready.
So let's do it.
All right. So like I said, we want to take regular everyday textiles that we have at home and transform it into magical experience. And you're absolutely right. Kids expect things to do, you know, pop out of everywhere these days, especially when they see gadgets. But somehow, when they see textiles, they understand it as a material that they sit on, they play on. They don't expect something magical to come out of there. So it's been great to just see the kids' reaction to a rug that's coming alive. And I want to show you, I know there's very little time. So what happens is you have a story on the rug of a boy called Milo and his jungle friends who explores all the things that happens in the jungle. You have some of the story in the app, which works on both Android and iOS. It happens like a regular story on an app, and then interspersed are these moments of augmented reality. You'll see an image, which we call as a marker, show up on the screen, and all you'd have to do is then try and match that onto what the pattern on the rug, and then you have the whole story that comes alive, and you have this river running down your living room, and kids love that, and they feel like they can really get close to the characters. And that's Milo and his friends doing a bit of yoga. And then the story goes on, and we have some activities for them, for kids to get engaged in as well. We feel like Spin Tales is not a story that you listen to, it's something that you do. It's an active and interactive experience. So we get the kids to do some yoga that they practice with the froggy, so some froggy yoga. And then again, it continues on to other moments where you have to try and match. This is a little tricky one. So you get much more sort of more immersive experience of Milo meeting all the toucans in the forest.
Pretty cool. So I want to do something really meta here. Okay,
sure.
Do you mind? Point your camera at this table. I'm going to use your app to show this. Can you do that? Here, take that.
Oh.
Yeah, I want to use your,
point at
this.
Camera.
I need your camera.
Oh, need a camera.
Sorry. Oops.
Yeah. Just.
I almost had the most meta thing. I just love taking
you there?
Yeah. All right, good.
You can touch the button. Right. Touch the button. Do you?
But it's just so cool. So now I'm holding a hen in my... on my card. I've seen this with baseball cards. Where the baseball player... Oh, that's creepy. That's just too close to my fingers. So you got the idea, all right? This stuff is evolving and it's so cool.
Zebra.
And... I'm using your iPad to do this.
Sure.
See, we all cooperate to make this stuff work. I'm sorry to interrupt your demo,
Okay.
You got the idea? Did you get your main points in?
Yeah, I think so.
And I'm standing.
Yeah, it's a regular rug. You can throw it in the wash. Use it. You know, it works as a regular rug, but it has this added value of storytelling and immersive, interactive experience. And we feel like this is one way of revolutionizing storytelling for children. And pulling them back into the physical world, where we're merging the boundaries between the digital and physical world. And we hope you'll come by to our booth. It's in the Sands Hall, 44538. We're right next to Neo Bear, so come find us. And we'd love to show you more.
Thank you, guys.